explain the you said about debt and ASU and athletic?
Yeah, a lot of athletic programs around the country, they borrow money from their universities and then they carry debt with their universities. And so we've eliminated all of that. We have built a structure now for finances which can weather any hurricane going forward, any tumult that we might encounter. We found ways. We built the Athletic Facilities District as a legal entity which generates the revenue to build things like this stadium. We've created all types of other financial structures that are going to allow ASU athletics to be able to advance. We came through the pandemic with no debt. We came through the pandemic with no layoffs in the university, no reductions in salary, no furloughs. So we've built a financial structure, and what's happened in the past was that athletics was considered a separate thing called an auxiliary enterprise. It's not an auxiliary enterprise now. It's in the core of the enterprise of ASU itself. And so we've changed the financial model that's going to allow us to have our athletic department focus on victory and success of our student athletes academically and athletically. And the rest of the enterprise is going to worry about the bigger financial issues. There's going to be revenue generation is still a responsibility of every unit within the institution, including athletics. So every unit, every director, every dean, everyone has to generate money, raise funds, build partnerships, find philanthropists that are willing to invest, generate revenue through participation, every unit. And so what it means then, therefore, though, is that we're going to have an opportunity for the athletic department to not be burdened by trying to carry the totality of all of its fixed costs. The rest of the university didn't have fixed costs that they had to worry about, but the athletics department did. We've eliminated that, restructured that in its entirety. So Graham, wherever he went, where'd he go? Graham and his team will focus on filling the stadiums, finding the best coaches, the best athletes, winning the games, producing great student athlete graduates, raising money, building NIL funding, building corporate sponsorships, raising philanthropy, but they won't have to worry about the core things that have drugged so many athletic departments down.
So, Dr. early in the year, you talked about wanting to streamline operations. That's why the process took 6 months. A lot of fans were questioning why the process would take 6 months if they're going to hire somebody internally. Why not give more consideration to external candidates? What would be your answer to those fans?
Yeah, well, so 6 months in the scheme of things, and we're trying to build a multi-decadal trajectory here. We're trying to build something for the next 20, 30, or 40 years. So taking a few months to reconstruct ourselves financially, to build our NIL presence, to change the financial model for the institution, to complete the NCAA investigation process. All of that needed to be done before we take this next step. So that's the reason for the timing.
And as far as that, not really considering external candidates wanting to hire from within?
We considered every possible candidate you can imagine as we're thinking about things. You know, we had innumerable people present themselves to us. Innumerable people that we already are aware of. I've been in this job for 22 years. I've interacted with dozens and dozens and dozens of traditional athletic directors from traditional type modeled programs. And what we needed was the executive that we've hired.
When you make a hire like this so important, you know, the relationships are important, especially relationship with you. Having known him and seen what he can do, how valuable is that knowing who you already have and you guys can get a piggyback on what you've already accomplished?
Fantastic. I think I was calling him from my recent international trip, and in fact, I know I was. And so it's what we have in Graham is an executive who understands why the university is here, why athletics are such an important part of the university, why we have to work together as a team, not as two separate things, why this has all got to come together to build Arizona, to build Greater Phoenix, to build the Sun Devil Nation. He understands all of that, so we are in complete alignment.
When did you know he was the man for the job?
Well, it's a process. So you watch someone as they're moving through meeting after meeting after meeting, issue after issue after issue. And so, Graham constantly stepped up to meet the challenge, constantly adjusted to the model that we were putting in place, constantly was contributing to the model. And that's what we were looking to see. Did we have someone that had that capacity? And the answer is we do.
How many candidates did you interview formally? You said you kind of considered all and people reached out, but how many did you actually interview?
Zero.
Got one more.
Dr. Crowley, you mentioned being past the NCAA investigation. I understand that there's a bifurcated process and there's an ongoing component to that, but are there additional things that you could say now that you weren't able to say previously as it relates to punishments of individuals from Edwards and others, and your thoughts on the determinations and the penalties?
Well, what we had was a great outcome. I'm not going to walk through every individual participant or what have you. We can have another conversation about those things, not for today. But, you know, we believe that the NCAA concluded that we did a great job identifying the problem, solving the problem, and finding a way to move forward, and our penalties reflect their perception of the job that we did.
Good.
All right.
Thanks, gang.
Thank you.